The environment is the entire world we live in. That's why we need to worry, both for the generations today and generations into the future.
Climate change is the most pressing issue of our time, and we need to act on it now. One of the biggest dangers is that we leave it too long and we end up with feedback loops that will make it worse. That was really one of the main reasons I went back to study.
I study at the Burwood campus of Deakin. I really like that it's next to the Gardiners Creek. We do a lot of prac work down by the river, some lot of hands-on activities. What I enjoy about studying environmental management sustainability is that the course is very holistic. You get to have a taste of all the different aspects of environmental management, whether it's wildlife, waste, water, climate change. There's so many different things you can go into. You can really tailor it to your passions and interests.
The teaching staff at Deakin are really approachable. I'm the sort of student who asks lots of questions, and that hasn't been a problem in my experience.
You really get the world experts on these topics coming to Deakin to teach you in their specialty, and they know the industry today, they're always out and about. They can tell you what's going on in the field right now.
Within the Deakin course, we have a number of opportunities to go on day field trips.
We did things like going to coastal and catchment management, so we went all around the bay and looked at different types of landscapes. But we also learn about the policy that affects the different types of waste management to begin with, so learning about reducing, reusing, recycling, and also how to go about community engagement to try to get some of those messages across.
Over this previous summer, I had the opportunity to travel to the South Pacific, to Tuvalu, and see firsthand the real challenges of waste management, where they're too far from anything to recycle. It costs $2,000 a tonne in Tuvalu to send goods to recycle. Seeing firsthand the scale of some of the issues and also some of the challenges and barriers, and starting to think in both a specific way and a global way how we can solve those challenges.
The expeditions we go on are really to give you a real world perspective on the problems that you learn in the classroom. So going out into the field, learning how the industry really works, how the policies are being put into action or not being put into action, it gives you a much more broad perspective on the things that you learn in the classroom.
Quite proud of the way that I've been able to get back into study and relearn how to study, particularly as a mature student.
Right now I'm working at a not-for-profit. We're working with environmental professionals, so I get to meet a lot of different people from these different industries and learn about what they're doing. But I'd like to go into sustainable development and apply my environmental management sustainability knowledge in that area.
There's a lot of opportunities in environmental management, not just within the environmental sector, but across the board.
Environmental planning, environmental policy, sustainability, a lot of people go into government, water management, waste management, working with Parks Victoria out in the natural environment, the world's your oyster.